consolidated balance sheet. Balance sheet as on 31/3/2005. Come to the liability side of the balance sheet. Share capital, the shares of rupees 10 each fully paid. So face value of one share is rupees 10. And the share capital of H Limited is rupees 7,50,000. Share capital of S Limited is 1,50,000. Profit and loss account, in case of H Limited, it is 3 lakhs. In case of S Limited, 90,000. Reserves, 90,000 in H Limited and 45,000 in S Limited. Bills payable, 22,500 in S Limited. Creditors, 1,65,000 in H Limited and 90,000 in S Limited. Come to the asset side. Fixed assets, 6 lakhs in H Limited and 90,000 in S Limited. Stock, 4,50,000 in H Limited and 1,80,000 in S Limited. Debtors for H Limited, 1,12,500. And for S Limited, debtors is 1,27,500. Bills receivable for H Limited is 30,000. Shares in S Limited, 11,250 shares. At cost, 1,12,500. So from this we can find out, we can come to know that H Limited is the holding company and S Limited is the subsidiary company. And number of shares purchased by H Limited from S Limited is 11,250 at a cost of rupees 1,12,500. The total of the balance sheet is for H Limited 13,05,000, for S Limited 3,97,500. The bills accepted by S Limited are all in favor of H Limited. So come to the liability side. Bills payable in S Limited is 22,500. They are all accepted in favor of H Limited. So intercompany transactions or intercompany owings, this 22,500 must be deducted from bills payable on the liability side and from bills receivable on the asset side of the consolidated balance sheet. The next one is the stock of H Limited includes rupees 25,000 bought from S Limited at a profit to the latter of 20% on sales. So the stock is selling price and the rate of profit given in the problem is profit on sales. It is 20% on sales. So we can calculate the amount of profit included in the stock directly by applying 20% on 25,000 to find out unrealized profit or stock reserve. All the profits of subsidiary company are earned by it since, that is after the shares were acquired by H Limited. But already there was a reserve of rupees 30,000 at that date. That is at that date means on the date of acquisition. So reserve in subsidiary company on the date of acquisition is rupees 30,000. Other than this 30,000, other reserves and profits are earned by the subsidiary company since acquisition. It is after acquisition of shares by the holding company. Let us now look at the solution of the problem. H Limited is the holding company and S Limited is the subsidiary company. In this problem, date of acquisition is not given. Share in S Limited. So, rupees 1,50,000 divided by face value rupees 10, which is equal to 15,000 shares. So, number of shares in S Limited is 15,000 shares. And H Limited share. H Limited has purchased 11,250 shares from S Limited. So, 11,250 shares divided by 15,000 shares. So, H Limited, this holding company share is 3/4. So, the remaining 3,750 shares are held by the minority shareholders or outsiders. And now calculate minority share, which is equal to 3,750 divided by 15,000, which comes to 1/4. Calculation of minority interest. For calculating minority interest, first take the paid up capital held by outsiders. First paid up capital held by outsiders add minority share in profit and loss account. of subsidiary company, that is 90,000 into 1 by 4, 22,500. Add 1/4 on reserves in subsidiary company, 1 by 4 into 45,000, which is equal to 11,250. Add up all these three amounts, and the total amount of minority interest is ₹71,250. So next, calculate capital profits. In this problem, capital profit is equal to reserves on the date of acquisition. So only reserves on the date of acquisition is given in the additional information. So take ₹30,000 as capital profit. H Limited share in capital profit, that is holding company share in capital profit, is equal to 30,000 into 3 by 4, which is equal to 22,500. Next, calculate revenue profit. So revenue profits are profits earned after the date of acquisition. So all the profits were earned since acquisition. It is given in the problem like this. All the profits were earned by the subsidiary company since acquisition. It is after acquisition. So profit and loss account in S Limited, this entire profit of 90,000 has been earned by the subsidiary company only after acquisition. So take the entire amount. And regarding reserves, the total amount of reserves held in the subsidiary company is 45,000. And out of 45,000, 30,000 is a capital profit. It is reserves on the date of acquisition. So deduct 30,000 from 45,000 to get the revenue portion, that is 15,000. Add up these two items and the revenue profit is equal to 1,05,000. Next, find out the holding company share in revenue profits. So H Limited share in revenue profits is equal to 1,05,000 into 3 by 4, which is equal to 78,750. This holding company share in revenue profits must be added to the profit and loss account while preparing consolidated balance sheet, and this minority interest will appear on the liability side of the consolidated balance sheet. Next, calculate cost of control or capital reserve. So first we should take amount paid for purchasing shares. Amount paid by H Limited for purchasing shares given in the balance sheet is 1,12,500. From this, deduct face value of 11,250 shares, which is also 1,12,500. So balance is nil. Deduct holding company share in capital profits, 22,500. So minus 22,500. The balance amount is capital reserve, which is shown on the liability side under the heading reserves and surplus while preparing consolidated balance sheet. So next, calculate stock reserve or unrealized profit. Goods remaining unsold at selling price is equal to ₹25,000, and rate of profit given in the problem is 20% on sales. So profit is directly given. It is given directly on sales. So just apply the profit rate on sales, that is selling price. 25,000 unrealized profit, that is profit on unsold goods, is equal to 25,000 into 20 by 100, which is equal to ₹5,000. So unrealized profit or stock reserve is 5,000, which must be deducted from stock on the asset side of the consolidated balance sheet and from the profit and loss account on the liability side of the consolidated balance sheet.